India's campaign at the 47th King's Cup has ended with a victory for a change. We've beaten Thailand 1-0 at home in Buriram. Unfortunately, the tournament has concluded without us being there, but we are still reviewing it. We're still looking at all the highlights from today's game, as well as an overall recap of how Stimac has done in his first sort of overseas trip with the Indian national men's football team. Arjun Pandit is with us. He's from coming to us directly from the sets of one of the most successful soap operas in the history of this nation. We will not mention which one. Vaibhav Raghunandan is in studio. How's the game, guys? Fun victory?
I mean, not a fun victory, but a victory.
नहीं सर, थाईलैंड में आपने थाईलैंड को हराया है, ऊपर से आपने थाईलैंड के खिलाफ क्लीन शीट रखा है यार. और ये नहीं कि मतलब ये फ्रेंडली इनकाउंटर है सर, ये थर्ड और फोर्थ के बीच में इनकाउंटर है. मतलब इसमें कुछ क्या कहते हैं, देयर इज सम वैल्यू इन दिस गेम. ये बहुत बड़ी जीत है मेरे हिसाब से यार. आपको चाहे गेम प्ले इतना पसंद नहीं आया हो या जो भी नहीं पसंद आया हो, फेयर इनफ, पर आपने ये जीत सुनील छेत्री के बिना करी है. आपने ये जीत करीबन 5 से 6 फर्स्ट टीम प्लेयर्स के बिना करी है यार. दैट इन इटसेल्फ इज अ ह्यूज विक्ट्री, एंड दैट शोज यू हाउ गुड द सप्लाई लाइन ऑफ इंडियन फुटबॉल इज. समथिंग वी वुडंट हैव सेड 7-8 months or a year back, we would have probably not said that, because whenever we were talking Indian football, whenever we were seeing the boys come out and play, it was that same set of 12-13 players. पर यहाँ पे इन दो मुकाबलों में आपको साफ साफ दिख गया कि आपके पास एटलीस्ट 18 से 19 खिलाड़ी हैं
जो सेम लेवल पे कंपीट कर सकते हैं फॉर दोस स्टार्टिंग 11 पोजीशंस. राइट, ओके. सो सिंस यू टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्लेयर्स, आई वांट टू आस्क बोथ यू गाइस योर टॉप पिक्स, कपल ऑफ गाइस, लेट्स से 3 प्लेयर्स दैट यू थिंक स्टूड आउट द मोस्ट फॉर इंडिया. ऑफ कोर्स वी आर नॉट गेटिंग इनटू टू मच एनालिसिस ऑफ द ऑपोजिशन
ओवर द कोर्स ऑफ द टूर्नामेंट.
Well, no, this game to start with.
This game to start with, Adil Khan, obviously. Like, he's the man of the match by far. Got an assist. Got a lot of crucial intercepts.
Should have had 2 assists.
Yeah, should have had 2 assists. Had a lot of interceptions, last ditch tackles, and combined very well. Worked very well with Jhingan. Also, I think it's a great arc for him to have completed in terms of his professional career. He just 4 years back, he had a really bad injury, went through a torrid time, came back, first appearance for the Indian team in this long period, and he's capped it off with a superb performance. So, full marks to him. He's definitely the pick for the man of the match. I can see that maybe some people would want to give it to Thapa, but I would pick Adil.
Yeah, I totally agree with Vaibhav on the fact that man of the match to mujhe pata nahi isme, but I am firstly so happy for Adil yaar.
Yeah.
Purely because of what Vaibhav mentioned right now, because it is not easy to come back from injury. Then on top of that, he's gone through 2 or 3 seasons of the ISL. Yeah. Jahan pe everyone who is involved in the ISL, who is watching the game, who is talking about the game, is saying, yaar, is ladke ko India camp mein bula hi nahi rahe yaar. Ab aap ye socho ki wo kuch keh nahi raha. But when you're hearing so many people talk about it, that in itself can demotivate you. कि मतलब आप लगे हुए हो, आप गोल मार रहे हो, आप कभी डिफेंडर खेल रहे हो, आप कभी मिडफील्ड खेल रहे हो, पर आपका नाम इंडिया कॉलअप में आ ही नहीं रहा. हाँ, यू माइट बी अर्निंग सम डिसेंट मनी फॉर व्हिचएवर क्लब यू आर प्लेइंग इन द ISL, बट इफ यू आर नॉट गेटिंग सिलेक्टेड फॉर द इंडियन टीम, दैट इन इटसेल्फ इज अ मेजर डीमोटिवेटर, इफ आई मे से. इज नॉट, यू नो, गोइंग फॉरवर्ड, आई डोंट नो व्हाट दैट, आई डिडंट गेट द राइट वर्ड, बट डीमोटिवेट इज अ गुड वर्ड, राइट?
So, sounds like a profession. What do you do? I'm a demotivator.
I'm a dementor.
No, so also, Adil, the thing is that as soon as you saw him play today, straight away, he sat into that position, yeah. Something that didn't come across in the first game versus Curaçao. Yeah. And straight away, there was some telepathic understanding between Sandesh and Adil. Mm-hmm. And the best part about Adil is, why I say that he can sort of replace someone like an Anas, is because he has an Anas-like quality, that is to throw himself in the line of the ball. He is not bothered about ki mujhe chot lagegi, mujhe kya hone wala hai. He will go in to defend that ball, right? Now, of course, tactically, he'll have to build an understanding with Sandesh, and that will only come over time. Remember, this is the first game that these two guys are playing as stopper back. Adil started out his career as a midfielder, by the way, right? So now he's being brought back into defense. So it will take time. So that was a major positive. But if you look back at some of the players that have really stood out for India over the course of these two games, then it would have to be the boys from the midfield there. One is Amarjeet, the 17-year-old boy, the under-17 boy, and I'll put my hand up. I think, Annie, you will also agree, from that under-17 team, if we thought we had to pick one player who would break into the senior Indian team, neither of us would have taken his name.
Yeah, it would have been Boris.
Would have been Boris, would have been Komal Thattal, would have been Aniket Jadhav. Amarjeet Kyam would have not been on our list, right? So full respect and credit to the coach ki usne 10 din mein is ladke mein kuch dekha hai. 10 din mein is ladke mein kuch dekha hai aur usne pehle game mein thoda khilaya aur pehle game mein itna impress ho gaya ki dusre game mein usko start de diya yaar. Now that boy, uska to chhati matlab chauda ho gaya hoga, and I can understand why. He does the basics very, you know, he's very good at doing the basics correct. And that's why I call him a very intelligent player. Now, intelligent player is not just one who can see the gaps and who can open the game, who can do some skill.
Yeah.
An intelligent player is who knows where to run off the ball.
Yeah.
Of his position, who knows how to make himself available to his players.
Yeah.
And once he gets the ball, I don't think he makes too many mistakes because he has a very simple game. Ball aaya, one touch. Second touch release.
Fair enough.
So that is one player who can be developed going forward.
Hmm.
You know, you give him 10 games in the year 2019,
hmm.
and you probably have a solid central midfielder then going forward.
So we were talking about the central midfield or the midfield in general, and the average age of this midfield. And except if you remove Jackie from the equation, who came in a little late into the game, you have Amarjeet, who's 20. You have Thapa, who is 21. You have Sahel, who is another
22.
Youngster.
Vinith Rai.
Pranay is not old by any stretch.
Vinith Rai. 22. Right? Who also did a very good job, by the way, right in front of the defense today.
Yeah.
Like, I just want
even
to say
Rainier,
that.
Even Rainier, Brandon, all these guys.
Rainier, man.
Very
young set of players that can really be groomed into something special. And special in the sense, of course, in terms of perhaps their technical abilities, they're not going to improve by leaps and bounds. But at least, like you're saying, awareness, your tactical understanding of the game, your telepathy with your teammates and how you work. I think there's plenty of potential here plenty of things to be at least somewhat excited about.
Yeah.
I still think like that enforcer role, the ball winning midfielder, that's a bit more problematic. But at least from the looks of it, these guys, the way they are, and Thapa, man, for me, has consistently been one of the solid performers.
Mm.
You know, like he also gets in there defensively. So he
yeah,
had
today
that,
he had
that
clearance off the line,
that might have been an equalizer for Thailand.
Yeah.
And he's always there when
he's
when
always covering up. Yeah,
he's always
covering.
He's in and around
he's always
the box,
there.
In those spaces, cutting off the lanes, trying to intercept and move
True,
the ball
he's always
forward.
Doing that.
And going forward, of course, so he has good vision and already...
So actually, time. Off the ball running, I think that's where up front, there isn't enough happening. Like, that's one big drawback for the team over this game, definitely.
Hmm.
Because there was no Sunil playing this game. And we started with Balwant and... who did we start with?
Farooq.
Farooq Chaudhary.
Yeah, and I didn't think that they offered much in terms of going up front. In fact, in the live blog, I'd also at a certain point, I just had this little observation where I felt that in the game against Thailand in the Asian Cup, Ashiq was playing and he was constantly pressing Thailand so high up the pitch that he was making their defense really nervous, and we were winning the ball in like areas where we could just quickly break them down.
Yeah.
So maybe
I felt like, I don't know if you guys agree and you could tell me how you feel about this, but one of the sort of slight drawbacks of this game plan was having no pace in the side, even though you're essentially playing what is a counter-attacking
attacking
system.
Game. That's what happened
like
in that one.
Where Adil should have had the second
absolutely.
Assist. He basically cleared the ball long and it was a one-on-one. It should have been a one-on-one chance between our striker, who's Farooq, and the Thai goalkeeper. But Farooq didn't have the legs to make it a one-on-one situation.
So
I also feel like the ground was a bit slow.
If you're
and Indian team ki baat kar rahe ho, and you're saying which is your strongest Indian team going into the Intercontinental Cup, right? Hopefully then Ashiq Kurunian should be back. I don't know the extent of his injury and why he's not part of the squad. But if Ashiq comes back, if Sunil is back, if Udanta's space is there, and then you have these young boys running the midfield, you said 20, 21, 22, you forgot Brandon Fernandes as well, who is not, I don't know how old is he, I think 23, 24, he's that age, or 25. Now the good thing with these young boys is, that they move the ball a lot quicker as well.
Yeah.
Yes.
You get that? And as a result, that transition from midfield to attack is also a lot faster. A couple of the one-touch, two-touch play, the triangles these guys were creating, that was so much better because they give the ball and they move ahead to, of course, straight away to make space to ask for the next ball again.
Again, yeah, I think a better judge of what the Indian team will look like, what we're going to play like and what the next steps are is probably going to be made at the Intercontinental Cup because Stimac has put out two 11s which are completely different personnel. And I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I cannot get a hold on what kind of game he wants to play. I don't think he,
yeah,
I wouldn't want to second guess him.
We had said, like Pandit had said when we did the last show, we should give, we shouldn't really try and...
Absolutely, yeah. Agree. Yeah. We shouldn't second guess him. There's no need to do that. Like, I think
when you're watching the games, the commentators apparently understood a great deal about Stimac's philosophy from watching these two games. I didn't have any such understanding. I think... like you had said, we should wait till the end of the Intercontinental Cup,
yes,
and then we will know what kind of football he wants to play.
Exactly.
Right now, he's just getting a feel of his players or wo competitive situation mein kaise react karte hain. Aur apne wo ek system mein kaise ek dusre ke saath kaise taalmel hai unka.
Absolutely. I mean, he's basically just trying to figure out his first 11 right now, essentially, in a certain
way. Matlab,
yeah. Fair enough. But aaj ek aur cheez dekhne ko mili hai ki agar hamare samne ek aisi team hai, who cannot physically enforce them on us.
Yeah.
Something like what a Kurosawa did.
Yeah.
Because today was a Thailand.
Yeah.
Then we are a lot more in this game.
Yeah.
Right? We hold the ball a lot more. And we can even cover space a lot more. We can even mark a lot better. Something that was not happening in Kurosawa. We were always a step or two behind the Kurosawa players. Today versus Thailand, they were not finding that much space as well.
Yeah.
Yes, their crossing and their set pieces were very good. And, you know, the... because of that, they didn't score, so you'd have to say their finishing was really poor.
Yeah.
But other than that, India was a lot more compact as opposed to what they were versus Kurosawa. So you got a good reaction in the second game.
Yeah.
Definitely.
I think they were not able to stretch us or stretch the game as much as Kurosawa did to find...
I think their best chances came right at the end of the game in perhaps injury time when they had a couple of those... close misses, a couple of headers or something, but yeah.
So and speaking of the misses, I mean, I didn't really see through the 90 minutes any clear cut chances for Thailand, which matlab, which absolutely should have been a goal. There were, it was whatever close chances of, like you said, crosses and set pieces that did materialize. For me, they came from communication mistakes between either the goalkeeper and his defense, or from slightly poor decision making in terms of when to come off your line and when to commit to going for that aerial ball on the goalkeeper's part. Do you guys agree that this communication issue is something that is persisting and needs
bhai,
to be worked
on? Aap communication ki baat kar rahe ho. Communication, agar hum show bhi karte hain, hamari jo telepathy hai, chahe hum ek dusre ko kitne school se jante honge, lekin show karne mein bhi time lagta hai and to build up that telepathy bhi time lagega. The same thing is on the field, yaar.
Yeah.
Right, and Amarinder might be used to doing something different at Mumbai City FC as opposed to now working with a Jingan and an Adil Khan who are playing for two completely different clubs. Right?
I think
and this is the he might be training with them, but when you start with them in a game, oh yeah, usko time lagta hai. Aapko time dena padega usko.
And I also think that he makes up for a lot of, I mean, this is not the best defense of someone who is making bad decisions. Say, but I would say that his athleticism makes up for a lot of the errors that perhaps his decision making puts him into, like in
like
the game today.
The
he came out today perhaps ill-timed, but then when he came out, he realized that he was not going to make the ball, so he would rather be better off blocking the header.
Yeah.
And he got close enough to put his body in the way for that. So that's that shows a certain amount of... And I think that when we talk about goalkeepers making bad decisions, again, Arjun is right, because defenders playing in front of the goalkeeper, sets of defenders play in different ways. Some of them like to drop back really deep and pick the ball off and head it out. Some of them like to leave the goalkeeper a certain amount of space.
Defense aapka jo kar raha hai, kar raha hai. But jo goalkeeper hota hai,
uska to make the call.
Hai, command of the area.
Yeah. So I think to take command of the area, you need to have a certain amount of...
But fair enough, time
lagega.
Deenge time, hopefully. He'll get more opportunities and
I
don't think Gurpreet's performance in the first game was so outstanding that he's convinced Stimac that he's the automatic number one. Maybe he has, maybe he hasn't.
That's a good thing.
We'll find out. Yeah, there should always be that competition.
Yeah, yeah, it's always nice to have. For every position.
Every position, sure.
Yeah.
I think the number one spot, the goalkeeper spot, is critical because of the kind of influence that that person needs to have, on, especially for India when we play competitive fixtures. Yeah, the keeper is a central figure in our system.
Yeah.
Anyway, so if you boys have nothing to add, we'll wind up on that note.
Just very quickly, yeah. If there is one big problem coming out of the King's Cup, it's the striking department.
Yeah.
लगता ही नहीं कि यहाँ पे goals कौन मारेगा यार.
Before, but yeah, we can just do a quick recap. Goals कौन मारेगा? Indeed, is a question. Any young players you think that might be sort of groomed to fill in that spot in the next few years?
See, there is something in Manveer Singh, right?
Yeah.
Because Constantine was backing him.
Plan B.
Now Stimac has come in and he's also played him.
Hmm.
Right, so clearly there is something in him, though you haven't seen much of him in the ISL, because even FC Goa,
yeah,
when they use Manveer Singh, they use him sparingly,
yeah,
because you've got Koro, of course,
yeah,
in that position,
yeah,
right? But my point is, ek bari Ashik Kurunian aa jayega, aur agar Chhetri fit ho jayega, to aapke paas do ready-made strikers aapke paas hain. But uske peeche Balwant Singh, mujhe lagta nahi abhi tak ki wo koi goal scoring option de rahe hain.
Or Joby Justin. I mean, I know that Stimac didn't pick him for this squad.
I haven't seen him
squad
in the international level. Yeah. I mean, whatever you've seen him do is do for East Bengal. Zameen Aasman ka farak hai yaar usme.
No, sure. But I mean, you can groom him maybe at the top level. Why not?
Yeah, I mean,
why not expect the coach to actually be able to influence him and bring his level up?
But bhai, wo international coach kitna influence karega usse yaar? Wo kitna time usse sab batayega?
Dekhna padega wo to, I guess.
I do think he'll get a chance to show us what he's got at some point in the near future. Maybe if not in the Intercontinental Cup, then in the qualifiers at some point, I'm sure. Once the season also starts to get underway and players are at a better level of fitness, they've had some time to recover. Also, remember, it's been a very long season for
these group of players.
Been at it for a long time.
I felt
the striker issue is something that we'll take up in greater detail. I think we can do a separate show on it, because we also need to talk about the club system. And how the foreign players that Indian clubs tend to buy are always in these critical positions, and that has a sort of knockdown effect on the development of Indian players. But we'll do that on a separate occasion. Let's wind this up for now. Pandit, enjoy your time with ESPN. Do good, win us the World Cup, and we'll see you back on our.
when you do finish painting all the windows behind you, let us know.
हाँ जी, अभी बस चाय आ रही है, थोड़ा ब्रेक है अभी, इसलिए मैं आ गया हूँ थोड़ा स्काइप पे.
Mazi, all the best. Thanks for taking the time. Thanks for watching, guys. Remember also that the Women's World Cup kicked off in France last night. The hosts had a big 4-0 victory against South Korea. But there are lots of Asian teams in action, lots of exciting football to look forward to. It's a month-long tournament where I think one of the few Indian media outlets to be accredited to that tournament, and we'll be covering all the big stories from the Women's World Cup. So stay tuned for the next episode of 420 Grams, which will deal with some of those stories. Until then, Shabba Khair.